Once again, welcome back to the plot. Okay, right, well, good afternoon, everybody. Once again, welcome back to the plot. I'm in my little greenhouse down home. I just want to sort this this camera out. As you can see, I'm getting a little bit chopper here with the propagators and whatnot. We're getting a little bit full, but no doubt, once next month comes, once April comes, we can start thinning them down and putting a few things up the pot. Today I'm going to start doing a little bit soon. I just want to show you these. I had loads of comments on Lobelia last week, and there we are. These have been in a fortnight now. You should be able to see them. Three perfect rows. Now they're nowhere near getting ready to be transplanted yet, so just bear with me. But as you can see, if I go close up, you can see they're just like watercress, very fine. A few of the young ladies were a bit confused about the amount of seed I was putting in. One packet of seed there was 2,000 seed, 2,500 in this one, and this is a mixed Lobelia, so they were around about 800 seeds per row. But as you can see, it's just like very fine grass, and when I start pricking these off, I'll prick them off into little clumps of sixes or even up to 10, depends on how big you want your plant. Nice little groups, and they'll go in different trays. But fortnight and they're up, they're through. Pansies are exactly the same, they're through. And that's just with a little plastic cover over the top. But as I say, take these off for morning, give them a wiping. And I sometimes do it of an evening and all, but as I say, once again, dampening off, that's the one thing you do want. Anybody can suffer from it, and that's one of the main reasons I use the chamomile tea, because the chamomile tea's got all them building properties that you give your plants a good soaking, and it just keeps them nice and clean. Fantastic stuff, cheap as chips, and it works. I've used it for years. Give you a seedlings of also good spraying. I'm just getting ready to sow the first of the tomorrows, but what I've done, I've filled the pots, pre-soaked them, and I've given them a spraying. Once again, there's my chamomile tea. Give the compost a really good soaking of chamomile tea, and that just gives you all that added protection. Now we're going to get myself up the plot later on, because I want to start sowing the first of the brassicas. Stacks of time for them. I never sow them any earlier till the beginning of March, and in a cold greenhouse, no heat whatsoever. So it's no good me sowing brassicas down here, because they'll come up too quick. You sow when you want them. You sow for when you want them. You got to get your timing right. I always sow the beginning of March. That gives us March, all of March, to let them grow on. I prick them off in April into little cups. They grow all through April, in the beginning of May, where they're nice sturdy plants, and they can go outside on the back bench with a little bit of cover to harden them off, and they'll be planted off middle of May in the garden. But that's it. That's the brassicas. That's all our brassicas. Cabbage, collie, sprouts. I mean, we can stagger them. We can get two or three decent crops, two or three different sets of seeding if we want. But the majority of them, the bulk of the sprout and the cabbage, I like to sow them. I'll be sowing them this afternoon, or if it turns cold again, it's focused for a little bit of rain this afternoon. If it turns cold again, and then we'll knock it off, and we'll go up again tomorrow. But what I want to do with the spring cabbage and the Japanese onions when we get up there, is to clean them up, get nice and clean, get them weed free, loosen the soil around them, and give them that first feed. Now, over the last couple of weeks, what I've been doing with the cabbage, if you remember, I showed you the nettle barrel a couple of weeks ago. We've been giving that a good stir, and we've been taking it out by the bucket loads and feeding the cabbages on that. So that's all I've had, just a bit of nettle juice. So now is the time to start thinking about the first feed. I can either use grow more, or I like to use night row choke. Easy enough to get a hold of at market gardens or allotment societies. I like to use a bit of night row choke on mine. So what I'll do, I'll go on the Jap onions, give them a good weeding out, and this Roger does it first thing in the morning. Now that means when I go up tomorrow afternoon, I just have to sprinkle on the night row choke. But my first seeds to be planted outside will be the parsnips. So we'll probably get them in at the back end of this video. I'll get the 2 rows of parsnips sown. I've got tapes this year. Parsnip tapes that I use for quite a few years now, and they're quite good. So we'll do that at the end of the video. So what I've done today, I've got a seed tray, and I'm standing my pots in here, and I'm using these small pots again for my tomatoes, and I'll probably get about 6 to 8 in each of them pots. I've got lids to go on them, so they'll be nice and secure. But what I've done with the tray, I've poured an inch layer of sand in the bottom of the tray, so they're sitting on the heat bed there, so there's not too much direct heat onto these pots. It just stays warm, but it'll not be too much direct heat. And what I can do, I can stand 6 of these pots in that tray, just like that, with our tops on, and then the cover over the top of that, and they'll be lovely and snug and warm, and they'll hopefully they'll come away nice and sharp. Your first tomatoes I want to get sown today are the ones I've caught Nolan. Once again, Carl, thanks very much. And these are Red Robin. Why I'm sowing these today is because I want them for this greenhouse in here. They only grow a foot tall, so they'd be perfect for on here. A nice pot, and the plant, because there's only 2 foot spacing in here, 2.5 foot, and they'll grow fine in here. That's the Red Robins. So I'm going to sow these now. I'll keep them in here. There's a little bit of heat on, so they'll grow really, really well in here. And by the middle of next month, when they're ready to pot off in the pots, hopefully I'll have at least one side of this cleared off, so I can get them into the pots, and we should get a nice early crop of cherry tomatoes. We love the cherry tomatoes, so I'm going to give these a try. As I say, I've never grown these before, the Red Robin, but I think they'll just be a perfect size for in here. Now I've just opened that packet up, and there's about 20 seed there, so I'm only going to use half of that. I'm going to do half a pinch once again, just sprinkling them out. There we are. I'll put them back in the packet. What I may do with them, I'll sow them up the allotment on the plot. I do sow tomatoes up there, but I don't sow it until April in the cold greenhouse. And of course, that's save for the next time. The ones I do plant out in April, or sow in April, of course, are the outdoor Ailsa Craig. Now you can grow these inside, in a cold greenhouse, grow fantastic, but you can grow them outside. So I'll be sowing them in April. I don't want them any earlier than June. And what I intend to do along the back there, the south facing wall, is to grow 3 or 4 nice tomatoes in there, just in one pot. And we'll make up a little bit of wigwam, bit of support, and see how they grow outside. They should be fairly easy to grow. I've grown Ailsa Craig for years, and they really are first class tomato. Now I've got 5 pots here. I've got 5 lots to sow. So I'm only going to do a couple there. I've got Ace 55. That's another good, nice round red tomato. I've got the Gardener's Delight. I've grown for years. You always get a first class crop off them. And of course, I always like to go for the British tomatoes, Tigrella. I've been asked to grow it for one of the residents over on the care home over there. I grew Tigrella a few years ago, and I was pretty successful with them. They're a striped tomato. Not everybody's taste, but I'd sow them. One of my all-time favourites, eye candy. And of course, never go past without sowing your moneymaker. Now, moneymaker is always our main crop. We'll get a first class crop of tomatoes from Moneymaker every year. So this is going to be my first one to sow the day. Okay, so I've got Carl's Red Robin in there, and then I'll sow the Moneymaker. I'll put the Moneymaker here, so I'm not going to get mixed up with having to make markers up just yet. I'll get these two sown. Now the Moneymaker, as I say, look at the back again, and it'll give you a seed count somewhere down there. 70 seed. So there's no way I'll be sowing 70 seed in one of these cups. At the most I'll sow 10, 6 to 10 seed, but I'm never in a hurry. These are just a few early seed I'm trying off early on, see if I can get a nice big plant ready for planting out in May. So I've got April 8th, May. I've got 9 weeks to get a really good strong plant for planting out. So your timing's everything. Get your timing right, then you'll not go wrong. So I've got about 10 seed there. Quite happy with that. That's enough for that pot. But what I'll do with these, I hate pricking off too early. I'll let these tomatoes get a good inch and a half to 2 inches before I even try to pot them off. And then I'll tip the whole pot will be tipped out and they'll just be broken up. Nice root system on them. A little bit of soil on them, and then pot it up into a cup, and they'll grow on first class. That's a money maker. So that's the two done. As I say, I'll have to make some markers up. As I say, I'll end up with 6 pots in here, like that. Different tomatoes, and then I've got the lids to go on them. Actually, great little things. They'll sit on there, and then of course I've got the cover just to sit over the whole lot. 6 pots will go in there, and then that'll go back in the heat bed, and hopefully they should be through within about a week. But I'm pleased as punch. Everything's grown away just nicely the way I wanted. I've just planted a few begonias this morning. That's the ones I saved off last year, the combs. What I've did is just filled a small pot up and pressed the begonia tubers. These were in I had some a tin with just some sawdust in. I had saved about 9 of my favourite ones from last year, the combs, and all I did was put them in a bit of sawdust and overwintered them. I've got a lovely comb, and of course yellow sulphur with it. So I've just planted them this morning. Hopefully we'll get some nice begonias off them. Dahlias are shooting away great, so hopefully in about a week's time there's a little split in the air and they're cloudy and the sun's just starting to peter through, so it's gonna make it a nice day. Yeah, as I say, the dahlias are starting to romp away, some lovely signs of growth coming on them, so I'm well chuffed for them. Hopefully in a fortnight's time, middle to the end of March, I'll take my cuttings. I'm quite happy with that, and that still gives us 10 weeks for planting out. Yeah, because as I say, June is early enough to plant your dahlias out up here. But we'll get up the plot and we'll get started on these what brassicas. But as I say, if you're a cold greenhouse, you don't need any heat whatsoever if you're planting brassicas, because they're one of them seeds that can just romp away within a couple of days, and if you're short of light, you're going to end up with brassicas 3 inches long and they're going to struggle. What you want is, I'll show you when we get up there, the same place as where I've got my sweet pea. I've just planted the dahlia, I've just planted the marigolds, and the brassicas are going exactly the same shelf, right up a height, where there's plenty of light, so they've got no chance of straining for light. They're up in the top there, the end of March now, so the weather's changing rapidly. We're getting the temperatures are coming up, and they're getting plenty of light, and that's all your brassicas will need. They do not need any heat. Cold greenhouse would be fine for them, and you want short, really stocky plants, and that way when you transplant them, you get a first class plant ready for planting out. But I'll show you all that when we get up the plot. For the time being, as I say, I've got I'm filling up here, and that's why I'm sowing the tomatoes in small pots. Usually I'll sow them in trays like this, small trays, a couple of dozen in there. But I'm starting to run out of room, so if I can get 6 cups in that tray, I'm over the moon, 6 different varieties. So I'm going to mark all these up before I leave here, get them all marked up, and then we'll get us out of the plot. We'll get started on the brassicas, and then I'll show you the jap onions, and of course the spring cabbage. Will put a feed on them. Okay, so see you at the plot. Bye for now. Okay, right, well, good afternoon everybody, different day again. Actually a little bit of snow this morning. Forget some tool. As I say, different day altogether this morning. Woke up to a little flurry of snow, so when the job was going to do this afternoon, I
I'm going to put that on hold because it's a little bit chilly today. I was going to try and get the parsnips prune here, but I think I'll leave that until the next video. What I want to get started on today is to get these tidied up. These are, of course, the Japanese onions. These have been there sitting here since back in the fair last October. Now, as I say, I never like to put mine in too early. To me, these are perfect. They don't look much at the moment, but I never like to get a big top on mine. If you plant them really early in September, you get quite a big onion. And of course, what happens when you get the winter coming, it's going to knock the tops over and really do some damage to them. So that's why I like mine nice and small. Back in October, beginning of November, is fine for sowing Jap onions. No earlier than that. As I say, they don't look much at the moment, but what's happening down below, it's a powerhouse. All the roots are built up, they've got a nice big root system. And of course, once the weather starts warming up, back end of this month, March, they're going to romp away. And I'll give you a first class onion in June. But today's about getting it just about tidying up. I think they're pretty weed free. Roger likes to keep on top of these, going along with the hoe every so often, keeping any weeds that grows in amongst them. Loosen that soil up, really keep it nice and free draining, so you don't get no puddles on the top. That's fine, just keep it nicely free draining, nice free of weeds. And of course, what we've got to, that's why I like to leave a good gap between my rows. I've got a nice bed here where I'm going to cut a row of parsnips, and the same on that side, but I'll do that in for the next video. But in between here, we've got another two rows, we've got three rows there. And what I'll put in between there is a row of Amsterdam forcing carrots. They're really large ones, and I'll get three rows in there. They'll grow up amongst onions, and hopefully keep the carrot root fly away. But, that's the idea anyway. But for a feed for these, nice spring feed, just along the edges, I like to put a couple of good handfuls of sulphur of nitro chalk. Now, nitro chalk, you can get it easy from the shops, or any allotment society, any garden, any big stores usually sell it. But I like to go to the allotment society and get mine by the bucket full, and it lasts me all season. But it's not just the Jap onions. We'll go down and I'll put a good sprinkling around the spring cabbage and give them a good boost. As I say, these don't look anything at the moment, but once the weather starts warming up, grass can come out, grass along the edges, just to see, like, keep them weed free, nicely broken up. And what we'll do here, we'll give this a good hoeing over, and then next week we'll sow the first of the parsnips. Hopefully it should be a bit warmer by then. It's still cold today, so I'm there. All I want to do is get these weeded out and get a good feed on them, good spring feed, and they'll be fine for the next day, for the next few weeks. We'll take that back down with us and we'll have a look at the spring cabbage, okay? Well, I've got to say, it's a wee bit warmer in here than say the pond tunnels. One of it is outside. I'm really pleased with the way these are growing now. Some of these round ones are just starting to harden up nicely. But once again, it's an easy job just to go through them. Take some of the dead leaves off. We've done these about a month ago. There's a few more. I like to start pulling leaves away from them. So if we do get any slugs, which we shouldn't have because they've had a couple of good sprains, and I've had a bit of garlic spray. And all I like to do is, once again, just go in amongst them. And the dead leaves, take them off. They can go up to the chickens and the lads up the allotment. Nice fresh green leaves there, but they're full of slug holes, or beetle holes. What I like to do is just take them off, put them in a bag, and then go for the chickens. that just stops any leaves they got that have been eaten away by little bugs and that. Just stops them there spreading any further. They're first class, them little cabbages. They're doing well. And all I've had is a couple of drinks of the nettle juice from last year. The bed was well prepared because we had sweet corn, we had maras and peppers, chilies, everything in this bed last year. So once all that was cleared, I gave it a really good manuring, good liming, and then in with the cabbages. But the cabbages, what the cabbages do is they soak up all the excess salts and that in the ground, and they take any excess manures that's here and just give it a really good clean, and you end up with a first class soil. Now once these come out, the tomatoes will be going in here this year. We'll use this bed for the tomatoes, so we'll do once the cabbages are out, we'll put our measure in and we'll see what numbers we're reading on the soil, and then we can take it from there. If it's a bit low, around about the 5 mark, we can add manure, add lime, whatever we need, blood, fish and bone, to bring it up. And if it's too high, we can take it back down with some potash, some wood ash and whatever, and we'll get the numbers around about the 6 mark for the tomatoes, and they'll be fine. But for the time being, once again, same as the Jap onions, we'll grow them with a little bit of nitro chalk, just a sprinkling around them. And then we've got the weepy hoses on now, and of course, there's no frost, so the hoses are clear. We can turn the tap on, so I can come up in the evening, put the tap on, and we can let it drip away all night. Come back in the morning, the beds are really nice and soaked. But as I say, it's just getting the nitro chalk and just sprinkling it around the plants, and that'll give them a really good spring boost. Hopefully we should get some nice cabbages at the start of next month, start of April, right through April into May, and of course by the end of May we'll have all the cabbages out ready for the tomatoes to go in. So that's another good growing season over once we get them out. Right, now what I want to concentrate on now is to try and get a few of these brassicas planted, so if we can go to the top of the 100 foot greenhouse, and we'll get a few seeds put in. Okay, right, well the sun's just trying to make an appearance. Actually it's quite mild up in the 100 foot greenhouse here. And see, I like to I've got not more room up here, and so I like to warm my sown down here and then take it to the different places in the greenhouse. The bottom greenhouse there, that's attached to a shed that's full at the moment, because what I've been sowing through the week is a lot of nigella, cornflowers, stuff like that. But what I like to sow them in is just little pots and just little cups, small cups, plastic cups like that. Fill them up and I put a half dozen seeds in them, and it makes a fantastic plant, especially for cornflower and stuff like that. I mean, you don't have to transplant them. Just put a few seed in there, light covering the compost, and they're great for just tipping out and putting in the garden in there for the summertime. That's like I said, nigella, cornflower. There's a few other bits and pieces I like sown that way. But for this afternoon, I want to get cracking on me brassicas. Now I did have them somewhere. Trying to find where I put them. I've got that many to go in. And of course, there's a tray full of them there. I've got about 5 different varieties of cabbage, and of course I've got my cauliflowers, I've got my lettuce, and I've got the sprout, and of course I've got some peas, some climbing bean and some peas to sow. So I've got to really get a move on. I've just potted a couple of roses up, my sister sent away for them, the Sir Tom rose there. So I've just potted them up. It's a little bit cold to go out, so they're going to sit there for a few weeks, and I'll put them out on the back bench just to make sure they don't get frosted. Right, so brassicas, I do every one exactly the same, whether it be sprout, curry, cabbage, also them exactly the same. Beginning of March, it's fine. They want to go up on your top shelf, no heat whatsoever. I never put any heat in with my brassicas. They need to go on the top shelf where you've got full light, and it's an easy job to do. Just one thing I would say is just don't over sow the trays.
I always sow mine in half trays like this. Now these are just my own compost, multi-purpose compost, mixed with the garden compost and some sharp sand. Well soaking them before about 10 minutes ago, and already they've run dry. So it just goes, it's show you how free draining my my compost is. Just make sure my hands are dry before opening this packet up. I know I've had one sown of these, and these are one of my favourite cabbage, the little pointer ones. They're great if you've only got a small space and you want to plant them really close together, and that's one of the best ones to grow, Greyhound. You get a lovely pointed sweet cabbage. I've grown that one for years, and there's two or three other really good cabbages I like to grow. I'm going to try the red cabbages. Yeah, I haven't grown them for quite a while, so I'm going to buy a pack of red cabbage and sow them. It'll be a bit early for them yet. I'll probably sow them around about the April time. And of course, with a small tray like this, as I say, if it doesn't matter what it is, sprouts, cauliflower, cabbage, I do exactly the same. Tip the seed out of my hand, and so I know what I've got in my hand. I can just look at that, and I reckon I've got about 3 dozen seeds there. For a small tray like that, ideal. I don't have any more than that. And it's just a case of picking them up and broadcasting them right across the top of that small tray. That's one tray done. Do exactly the same again, tip them out, same again. So I've got about 3 dozen. I've got a few more seed left in that packet there, but I'll leave them later on, and I can always make another sown around about the April time, which will give us a few cabbage to stick in where the Japanese onions come out. You've always got a bit of spare land. When you pull the Jap onions out, you'll have the carrots growing there. So all you do is pull the Japs out on about June time, and then I should have some nice little cabbages just to plant in that place. It's a quick cash crop that goes straight in, and it means you don't have any land lying vacant. So that's my first ones, that's my Greyhound, and then of course it's simple enough. I left a quarter of an inch here on the top. But as I always say, it doesn't matter how much room I've got on the top, because I never water from above anywhere. And it's as easy as that. I'll get my markers done, place my markers in there. That's my first tray. Now they'll just sit in this tray. As I say, I can just water the trays from underneath and they'll get a good soaking, but they'll sit right up on the top shelf here, up near the polythene roof, and they'll get full light. And then they'll be through within about a fortnight, even in a cold greenhouse. It'll take about a fortnight for them to come through. We'll let them grow on through this month, March, end of March. I'll prick them off at the end of this month into cups, and then they'll probably sit in cups once again up on the top shelf for another 2 or 3 weeks. And then they'll go out in the back bench outside with just a little bit of cover on the top. Let them harden off, and they'll be ready for planting out in May. So, easy enough job to do. That's a cabbage. As I say, I've got sprouts, I've got a nice collie, that's another good cabbage, Regency, that's another nice round one, and I've got one of my favourites, Wheeler's Imperial. Now Wheeler's Imperial I like to use for a spring green in the greenhouse, or you can sow it for a summer bin. It's multi-purpose. So whatever seeds you've got left out of there, if you buy Wheeler's Imperial, and you get loads of seed. I keep 450 seed, so even if you sow half of that at 200 plants, make sure you fold it back away properly, put it back in this packet, and then you can sow them in the September time, August, September, and you get a lovely cabbage for growing in your polytunnel or your cold greenhouse. And that's the way we like to grow ours. Mini coal, if you like a small cabbage, they're really nice because they're really tiny, but they're a ball head and you can get them absolutely rock solid, and plus they stand on the ground for quite a while without splitting. So that's another good one, mini coal. I've got the filter kraut, that's the ones I've grown a few years running. They're really massive. If you've got plenty of space, plenty of land, they're the cabbage you want, because they're absolutely massive and they'll feed a family of six quite easily, one cabbage. That's filter kraut, another good one. And I want my cauliflower. Well, I've got the all year round, my all time favourites. I'll be sowing some of them. And of course, there's another cabbage, Duncan. That's another fantastic one to grow. You can grow that also in the summer, as well as a spring cabbage. So there's lots of varieties to put there. Just a few of my favourites here. Treat them all exactly the same. Your sprouts, your collies. Sow them like that. Get them up on the top shelf in a cold greenhouse. And they'll be through within a couple of weeks' time. And of course, as I say, once they come through, I'll let you give them a good soaking. Even the legs of the cabbage, I'll let you give them a good soaking of chamomile tea. And that stops any dampening off. I know my compost is always nice and clean, but I always like to give them a good soaking with their chamomile tea, and that just keeps them nice and clean. So that's the cabbages started anyway. I want to go back outside, finish off the jack onion beds. I'll get all that hoed out this afternoon and get all the nitro chalk put on that bed. Spring cabbage will do it tomorrow. Get the whole bed completely weeded out and really a good feeding on, and that's that out the road, and then I come back to planting again. Maybe it's Sunday. I'll come here Sunday afternoon, nice and quiet, put the radio on, and get stuck into all me brassicas. Get all the sprouts sown, all the cauliflower sown, and whatever else needs doing. But that's the video for this week. I hope I've give you a few tips. As I say, now's the time to get outside and start feeding your plants that you've got out there. If you've got spring cabbage outside, and then by all means do exactly the same as what we've done in this polytunnel here. Just weed them out, give them a good hone, and put a good handful of nitro chalk around them, and they'll love you for it. They'll start to beef them up ready for the warm weather starting, and you'll get a first class cabbage out of them. So as I say, I'm going to knock off now, get out and get this video online. Thanks for all the comments again next week, off last week, great. Lots of people watching now. The tomatoes that were sowed yesterday, we'll probably make another sowing in about a fortnight's time, 3 weeks' time. Back in this month, I'll do another sowing of tomatoes. And then we'll be in April, we'll start sowing the courgettes, cucumbers, stuff like that. All that family, squash family, we'll leave until at least April, till the place starts warming up. But there's still lots to be done at the moment, loads of jobs to be getting on with. And I've got a lot of building work to do this week, so I'm hoping to repair a few of the beds, get that done, and then we'll be more or less on track. I'm going backwards and forwards to the stables for manure, get all the beds mucked, and then come the beginning of next month, April, we'll probably start on our outside potatoes. Well, inside ones are just starting to pop through the top there, but I'll show you that next week when we get started sowing the parsnips. Okay, so for the time being, watch what you're doing, enjoy yourselves in the plot, and I'll see you all again next week, okay?